Hello, and welcome to today's video of electrical materials, where today we will be covering magnetic permeability. The greater a material has magnetic permeability, the greater the conductivity for magnetic lines of force, where magnetic permeability is equal to the relative permeability times the permeability of free space, where permeability of free space is denoted as 4 pi times 10 to the negative 7 power henries over meters. Let's go ahead and further understand what this means by looking at an example. For our example, we are asked to calculate the magnetic permeability for the material carbon steel if its relative permeability is 100. So referring back to our formula, we can set up magnetic permeability, which is denoted as mu, to be equal to mu r times mu naught. So our relative permeability is given to be 100, and this is unitless because it is a ratio. And multiply this by 4 pi times 10 to the negative 7 with Henry over meters. When we multiply the two, we have our magnetic permeability is equal to 1.26 times 10 to the negative 4 Henry over meter. Let's go ahead and clear the board to look at another relationship for magnetic permeability. Another way we can define magnetic permeability is using the relationship between magnetic flux, denoted as B, over magnetic field strength, denoted as H, where magnetic flux is given in units Tesla, and magnetic field strength is given in amps over meters. The relationship between these three is that when magnetic flux B is high, and when magnetic field strength H is low, then we know that our magnetic permeability is low. On the other hand, if our magnetic flux is low and our magnetic field strength H is high, then we know that our magnetic permeability is high as well. Let's go ahead and look at an example to further understand. Our example states that the materials in a magnetic circuit have a magnetic field strength of 6.2 amperes over meters. Calculate the magnetic flux if the relative permeability is 120. So for our example, we are given our magnetic field strength, H, is equal to 6.2 amperes per meter, and our relative permeability, denoted as mu r, is equal to 120. So because we aren't given our magnetic permeability, we need to solve for it by multiplying our relative permeability times our permeability of free space. So let's go ahead and first rearrange our formula to solve for magnetic flux. So we have B is equal to magnetic permeability times our magnetic field strength. We can now go ahead and further expand this by writing the relative permeability, denoted as mu r, times the permeability of our free space, mu naught, multiplied by our magnetic field strength, H. So let's go ahead and clear the board to start plugging into our equation. So we can solve for our magnetic flux by first finding our magnetic permeability. So we can multiply 120 times 4 pi times 10 to the negative 7 Henry over meters. And then we would multiply this by our magnetic field strength, 6.2 amps over meters. So if we solve for our magnetic permeability, it is equal to 1.13 times 10 to the negative 4 Henry over meter times 6.2 amps over meter. We can then continue to solve for magnetic flux by multiplying our permeability by our magnetic field strength. So when we do so, we are left with 7.006 times 10 to the negative 4 Henry times amps and divided by meters squared. So we can actually go ahead and simplify our units. So Henry times amps gives us the unit Weber over meters squared. And this simplifies to the unit Tesla. This concludes our video on magnetic permeability. Thank you for watching.